Hello and welcome students. Today we will understand the application of international law and the application by Great Britain, the practice of Great Britain in applying international law. As we discussed in our earlier lecture that international law has been categorized into customary international law and the treaty laws, that is the conventions, treaties, contracts. Okay, so first you will deal with the customary international law, because Britain is dealing separately in these two categories of international law. So first, the customary international laws has to undergo two conditions. The first condition, as per the rules of international law are to be consistent with the existing statutes of Great Britain. So here Britain is not enacting new laws, new acts, but it is accepting the international rules or the international law as a part of incorporation theory. So whether the existing act of Britain is earlier or later to this particular international law, it will accept only if it is as per consistent and beneficial to its nation's social, economic or political conditions. After this condition is fulfilled, the next condition will by default be applicable, that is applicable to the courts. In this condition, once the scope of international law or rules has been determined by the British courts of final authority, that is what final authority we in India, that is the Supreme Court, the apex court in India. The same way, the Britain courts of final authority, if find scope and that scope is determined by the final authority, all British courts are thereafter bound by that determination. Even though a divergent customary rule of international law later develops, but the courts accept it has, because it has been already accepted in the statutes of Great Britain. So the international laws are accepted in the customary international laws as the incorporation theory. So, but there are certain exceptions. The exceptions are against the courts. That is, apart from the qualification, that earlier two qualifications, there are certain exceptions to the automatic applicability of customary international law by British municipal courts. This is relating to courts alone. Okay. First exception is acts of state by the executive, that is the crown. For example, a declaration of war or an annexation of territory may not be questioned by British municipal courts, notwithstanding that a breach of international law may have been involved. So the court cannot question its own state or its executive, which is executing its duty in regards to Crown's prerogative powers. So the courts cannot question the executive or the state, that is the Crown's prerogative powers. And the second exception is British municipal courts regard themselves as bound by a certificate or authoritative statement on behalf of the executive, that is to say the crown, in regard to certain matters falling peculiarly within the crown's prerogative powers. So again, it is again related with the prerogative powers of the crown in matters relating to de jure or de facto recognition of other states, or the sovereign nature of governments, and the diplomatic status of persons claiming jurisdictional immunity on the grounds of diplomatic privilege. Although such certificate or statement may be difficult to reconcile with existing rules of international law. So, in these matters are again the interference of a crown's prerogative powers. So, these are exception to the courts to not to go against the executive or the state for not following the international law. So, coming to the treaty laws, international treaty laws, there are again two conditions to be followed. So, even treaties are also international law. So, first, the treaties requiring parliamentary assent, and some treaties are there, those does not require the parliamentary assent, because again there is a special treaties, and because the treaties are made by the crown, the treaties are made by crown with the governed principles of constitution, so they doesn't need any parliamentary assent. Okay, to conclude, Britain is following the doctrine of incorporation theory, wherein there is no need to enact laws according to the customary rules or laws, but it is automatically incorporated in its municipal laws. And in regards to treaty rules, the treaty rules may or may not require the parliamentary assent as per the type of treaty, that is the special treaty or the treaties made by the crown, has an exception. See, but as an exception, the Britain's treaty rules does not apply against the European Community laws. But Britain has came out from the European Union as a member, this recently January 2020, so there may not be any exception in regards to international law. So, Britain may accept the international laws as per their convenience, or what you say, consistency with the national laws. So, chalo, thank you.